Motorists beware, a new rage is sweeping Philadelphia. It's studying old manhole covers. Manhole cover students are called Nortonists, in honor of Ralph Crampton's sewer-dwelling buddy Ed Norton. Manhole covers are unappreciated. Just think how treacherous travel is when manhole covers are missing or ajar. In the normal course of events, manhole covers are punished by weather and rubber, spat on and worse, but they're tangible reminders of our city's great business past. Keystone Telephone began service in 1902 to offer competition to Mighty Bell Telephone. Keystone introduced dial telephones to Philadelphia in 1913. Keystone was eventually absorbed by Bell in 1945. PRT stood for Philadelphia Rapid Transit. The city granted traction magnates Peter Widener and William Elkins a monopoly over all city transit when PRT was formed in 1907. They spent their lives in the gutter with great pride. Philadelphia's undisputed manhole cover kings were J. Alfred Clark and Simon Scullin. Look down. You'll see thousands of their iron discs all over the city. Scullin and Clark are unknown today, but their names may be written more in the Book of Philadelphia than those of Ben Franklin and John Wanamaker. Simon Scullin was born in 1839 in Ireland. He came from the clan of the O'Scullane, an Ulster name, and married Margaret Murray in 1860 in Valley Scullion in County Derry. Opportunity was non-existent for Simon Scullin in his native land. Scullin stayed briefly in Scotland and came to America in 1869 to open his iron foundry. The Scullin family foundry prospered at American and Cambria Streets in North Philly for over 100 years. The Scullin iron foundry also wrought their metal magic in other chapters of the Book of Philadelphia. Richard James invented the slinky in the Philadelphia Naval Shipyard. Richard James' father designed the patterns for the Scullin manhole covers in Scullin's Germantown shop. The Scullin foundry is credited with casting the iron cowcatchers for Philadelphia Rapid Transit trolleys. John Alfred Clark was born on Catherine Street in South Philadelphia. In 1908, Clark's iron foundry in Gray's Ferry took up almost an entire city square and gave employment to more than 6,000 men annually. Clark did sewer work for the city and in West Philadelphia built the trestles for the Market Street Elevated and roof supports for the Acme Bakery. The name of the W.H. Clark Foundry appears on countless Philadelphia manhole covers. W. Howard Clark was 13 when his father, J. Alfred, died. W.H. Clark put everything he had into his faith, family, and business. When his father died, the banks took over Clark's, but W.H. restored it to a major force in the iron foundry business. As Nortonists and lovers of street baseball, the boys of Souter Street in Northeast Philly were also pioneers in the recycling movement. We took the skinniest kid on the block, held him by the ankles, lowered him through a manhole cover to fish out our lost half balls, tennis balls, pinkies, and pimple balls. We conclude with the question that has puzzled those new to the study of manhole covers for years. Why are manhole covers round? A circle is the only shape that will not allow a manhole cover to fall into its hole. If you answered correctly, you are a Nortonist.